name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. This morning, boys and girls, as we prepare to celebrate our Mass, let us remember how much that Jesus loves us and forgives us of our sins as we say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christ eleison, Christ eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who govern all things both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, love is kind and patient, never jealous, boastful, proud, or rude. Love isn't selfish or quick-tempered. It doesn't keep a record of wrongs that others do. Love rejoices in the truth, but not in evil. Love is always supportive, loyal, helpful, and trusting. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
I called on the eyes from tears and my feet from stumbling. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. Jesus Christ, who brings us truth and grace. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "You have heard people say, 'Love your neighbors and hate your enemies.' But I tell you to love your enemies and to pray for anyone who mistreats you. Then you will be acting like your Father in heaven. He makes the sun rise on both good and bad people, and he sends rain for the ones who do right and for the ones who do wrong. If you love only those people who love you, will God reward you for that? Even tax collectors love their friends. If you greet only your friends, what's so great about that? Don't even unbelievers do that? But you must always act like your Father in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Well, boys and girls, in both of the readings today, we heard about kind of the same topic. Was anyone listening? What was the topic that we heard about? Okay, way in the back there. Love, that's right. And love is a very, very beautiful thing, okay? And sometimes we use love in the wrong way. Sometimes we'll say, "Oh, I love ice cream," okay? Well, you can like ice cream a lot, and I do too, but you can't really love it because it can't love you back, okay? And so love is important, like you love your parents and grandparents and people like that. So, but Jesus is telling us that we can't just love those people, the people that are kind and nice to us. He says we have to try to love everyone. And that is not always an easy thing to do. And that's why he tells us to pray for those who are mean to us. Because we all have had people that have been mean to us, right? And we probably all at some point have been mean to someone else, right? Yes, hopefully not, but probably yes. And so when people are mean to us, what's the normal thing we usually think of doing when someone's mean to us? That's right, I'm gonna be mean right back to you, okay? And I think that, you think that, sometimes we all think that. But Jesus is telling us that we shouldn't do that, okay? And I know sometimes as I've gotten older, I mean, I too have had people that have been mean to me, and I know I've been mean to people. Sometimes it's on purpose, but sometimes it's not really on purpose. We just maybe say something snotty that they take the wrong way. We shouldn't have said it, but it wasn't really meant as something bad. But sometimes people are just mean to us. And so One of the things that I have found is, like Jesus said, if you pray for those people that are mean to you, then it does help, okay? Because if I'm mad at someone and I'm carrying a mad spirit or a grudge, as we call it, in my heart, and I'm just angry at them when I see them, who does it hurt the most? Who does it hurt the most? Yes. Well, it hurts God, yes. But who also does it hurt a lot? Jesus. But it hurts, yes. Well, yeah, but actually it hurts somebody else more, yes. Yourself, that's right. Because the person you hold the grudge against, they probably don't care, okay? But when we're mad at someone or angry and we can't let go of that, it hurts us more than it hurts them. Because they'll go on with their lives and doing their things every day, but we're the ones that are like, oh, I don't like that person and I'm just so mad and I don't want to, you know, I want something bad to happen to them and all that. And so, boys and girls, that's what Jesus is telling us to do. It's not easy, but he's saying, now, he doesn't say we have to like everyone or that everyone has to be our friend, but he says that we should love those who are not nice to us and pray for them. And so it is not an easy thing to do. At 60 years old, I'm still trying to do it myself, but that's what Jesus is asking us to do. And if we do that, then we're acting just like Jesus. Now let us pray.
Our Father Rick, Archbishop Coakley, and Pope Francis, to lead us in our faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Blessed Stanley Rother and continued prayers for his canonization, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all may be inspired to work toward peace and justice throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Christ the King community, that we will work together to love others as Christ loves us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those struggling dealing with COVID, may they be surrounded with grace, peace, and strength. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers that we hold silently on our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty God, we ask you to hear these prayers and those that we hold in our hearts. Continue to show us your mercy and your love, and we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Nothing is impossible with God. Nothing is impossible with God, who raises the lowly and strengthens the weary with everlasting love. Not be afraid. God has called you by your name as a servant of the kingdom. Spread the message of God's love. The Lord has done wonderful things for me, done wonderful things. Nothing nothing is impossible with God. Nothing is impossible with God, who raises the lowly and strengthens the weary with everlasting love. Do not be afraid. God will strengthen you each day as a herald of the gospel. Tell the good news of God's reign. The Lord has done wonderful things for me, done wonderful things. Nothing is impossible with God. Nothing is impossible with God, who raises the lowly and strengthens the weary with everlasting love.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you,
and with
your spirit. Lift up your hearts, we lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, O Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Paul, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Remember especially Leon Fourquet. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Your spirit. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. On us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. I come with joy, a child of God, forgiven, loved, and free. The life of Jesus to recall, in love laid down for me. In love laid down for me. I come with Christians far and near to find, as all are fed, the new community of love in Christ's communion bread. In Christ's communion bread. As Christ breaks bread and bids us share, each proud division ends. The love that made us makes us one, and strangers now are friends. And strangers now are friends. The Spirit of the risen Christ, unseen but ever near, is in such friendship better known, alive among us here, alive among us here. Together met, together bound by all that God has done, we'll go with joy to the love that makes us one, the love that makes us one. I receive the living God. says, I am the vine, far from whom no life can grow. If you join yourself to me, a rich harvest you will know. I receive the living God, and my heart is full of joy.
Let's thank those who prepared our Mass for us today. Thank you very much. Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Blessed Stanley Rother, pray for us. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace.